All right, everyone, welcome to the video. This is part three of Getting Started with RabbitMQ. So in the first part, I gave you an overview of what RabbitMQ is. Second part was I walked you through creating your first RabbitMQ queue in the RabbitMQ UI. And now coming to the part three would be a Python. We'll write a code for RabbitMQ sender and receiver, client and server. Let's get started. All right, so first of all, I hope you have installed all the dependencies. So let's get started. So first of all, I'm going to say try, and I'm going to say import pcar, which is for the RabbitMQ, right? And if this module is not fine, I'm going to just raise an exception. I don't want to crash my program to crash. So I'm going to say exception as E. I'm going to say print some module, modu, modules are... All right, some modules are missing, and we can dump the error message right there. Format E. Yep, it should be fine. All right, so once that is done, what we can do is basically, I'm thinking, should I do a dry code or should I do an object-oriented code? Well, let's do the dry code first and then go with the object-oriented, state-of-the-art design pattern code. Right. So first of all, I need to define my connection, which is going to be pcar dot blocking. Right. Pcar dot blocking, and let me define my connection strings. Right. So in this, I'm going to define my connection. Right. So here I can say pcar dot. I can say connection parameter. So connection parameter. Okay. Oops. The C was capital. So connection parameters, right? And I can pass in my host name. That is, host would be a local, right? For or else you can say if you have deployed this on a server or something, then that IP address. So basically local host, right? We are doing a very simple example right now. We are not doing anything complicated. So now we need to create a channel, right? We will use a very simple channel for now. So, all right, so channel is equal to connection, so that we just created connection dot channel, right? Now we have our channel ready. Now we need to declare our queue. So channel dot queue, let me see. Channel dot declare queue, and the queue name is hello, right? That's what the name of the queue is right now. And we can do a very basic publish. We can just say channel dot basic. The IntelliJ should complete the stuff. I don't know why it's not completing that. I have to type, and I hate to type. So channel dot basic underscore, we can say publish. And we can say exchange. Let me do that. All right. So the exchange is nothing. I haven't defined any exchange, right? This is a very simple stuff. And the message is basically a hello world. In the later video, we'll do very complicated stuff. We'll be sending, images and stuff across RabbitMQ. So, yep. So, and after once everything is done, need to close the connection. Connection.close. And just for your, we can say, right, published message. We can go to the receiver. And let me just type the code. So, let's do import pcar. And if that is not there, accept exceptions as E, print some modules. All right, beautiful, lovely. Now let us define our receiver. So again, the same thing. We'll define our connection. Then we'll define our channel. So this can repeat, right? Then we'll define our channel. We did that in the last video. Because the reason I want to show is because this is not the good way of coding. I'm going to do a state of the art design patterns in this now. So after defining channel, we need to declare our queue, right? Which queue we want to read the data, and we'll just define a custom callback function. So that's my function. The function will take channel, method, properties, and bodies. So the channel, what channel we are working, method, properties, and bodies, right? Now we need to define the, since we are consuming, right? We are the consumer, this is a receiver, right? It's going to read the data from the queue. So we'll declare channel.basicConsume. Right, this is our basic consume, and at the end we can just say call the callback function, I mean just start the stuff. Right, now let me start the receiver, and this will consume all the messages from the queue. So here you can see waiting for messages, press Ctrl C to exit. Now this is my sender. I'm just gonna send my first payload, that is hello world. So published message, and if you go to the receiver, here you can see the message is received. I can also send images, byte images in the payload, anything that I want to. So if I run the code sender again, I should get two stuff. Yep, here you can see. This is good, not too bad, but not the my way of programming. Let me exit this. I have to do a hard reset maybe. Yeah, this won't exit now. Alright, so I have just terminated it. So the my way of programming is design patterns and object oriented, right? So let me do that. Let's do the sender part first. So this is good, not a big deal. What we can do is now, let's say we want to define a class, what is this? RabbitMQ. Right. Now, I'm gonna say self dot. Alright, so that's my connection object. Then I will define my channel similarly. And I want this to be private, so I'm gonna just give a single underscore. Self dot. Bring this channel up. Make this object private. And self dot connection. Right? Makes sense. Now we need to define our queue, or we need to declare our queue object. So I can just say a name, and by default this will be hello if you do not supply anything. So self, let's do, yeah, I need to define that self dot queue. Q-U-E-U-E is equal to the queue, right? Whatever name we pass in, and this will just take the self argument. So this will be not channel, this will be self dot underscore channel. Queue declare, and here instead of this, I would say self dot queue. Beautiful. Now let's define our payload, publish. Guess what, self dot. Remember underscore because it's a private attribute. What we wanna do is basically, this is, I wanna implement state of the art code, right? So I will define a payload, all I have to do is just give a JSON payload and it will publish it. So let's call payload, and this will be an empty dictionary right now. So body, I can pass in the string version of, and at the server, I can, what I can do is I can use the AST literal eval to convert that dict into a JSON payload back, right? So what I'll do is in the body, guys, string version of that payload, right? That's all I need to do, and all I need to do is close the connection. So self dot underscore connection dot close, right? All right, our RabbitMQ is ready. Let me just test it out if that works. So I'm gonna turn the receiver on right now. There should not be anything in the receiver. All right, my sender is this. Let me define my sensor value, let's say, because I wanna do something really amazing with this. Of course, I'm gonna implement singular design pattern also in this. So underscore underscore name. So all I need to do is server. I'm gonna create an object of server, RabbitMQ. Remember, we have to give the queue name. So the queue name would be hello. And all I have to do is basically say server dot publish, and my payload is equal to data hello, right? Let's look at this now. Okay, let me just also add a message here saying that it was done, and then we'll run it. Beautiful. Let's run the sender. So here you can see published, and let's check the receiver. And here we have the JSON data. We can do AST literal eval on this, and we can get the back the JSON data right here. Let me, if you are really very interested in coding, I mean, if you love it, let's do a meta class in this. Now the people will be like scratching their head right now. I know. Class, meta class, which is inherit from type. Sorry for the people who are beginners and watching this. So define call. I'm gonna define a singleton design pattern, right? So let's do a class. I do have my snippets of data structures, I think. Data structures and algorithms. Should open in a new tab always. So okay, so where was I? Okay, so here is my stuff. So that's what I need to implement. If class not in, that's my singular design pattern, of course. So let's do that. Let's type it. So we also have a practice of doing that. If class not in class dot underscore instance, then what we need to do is basically we want to create that instance. So class dot instance, and I think it'll take a class object. And we'll call the super method on this. We'll use IntelliJ's built-in method. I mean, I don't want to write the code. So of course, gonna take args quarks, and we need to return that object. Hopefully I'm doing it correct. So return class, yep, that's correct. And just need to return the class. So return class dot instance, right? Underscore instance, all right, hopefully that should be correct. Yep, so let me add singleton design pattern. All right, instead of inheriting from object, I'll say metaclass equals to metaclass. All right, state of the art. all right, what I can do is again, I can like generate a class known as sensor, which will generate a dummy data. But let's keep it easy, otherwise people will be scratching their head right now. So that's it for this tutorial. Hope you have enjoyed this RabbitMQ tutorial. If so, do give a like. I'm gonna make state-of-the-art code and I'm gonna publish my own library. So yeah, that's it for this video. If you have any more questions, please let them know in the comment section and I would be very happy to assist you. Thank you for watching.